Hi Libra, welcome to Pandora Astrology's monthly horoscope for December of 2020. This month's themes of communication and social life can be really well addressed in a natal and transit reading, which you could get with either Julia or me, and you can find it in the YouTube description below or by going to pandoraastrology.com/services. We've got Mercury, Venus, and Mars activity for you, also an eclipse and a change of sign for Saturn and Jupiter. Hey, Julia, you want to kick this thing off?
Sure. Well, hey there, Libra. I'll start with Mercury. That's the planet of communication. It represents your mind. And on December 1st, the very beginning of the month, it's going to enter your third house. The third house is the house of your neighborhood, all of your local surroundings. It also represents siblings and neighbors too. So you might be doing a lot of communicating. That might mean phone calls, emails, texts, either with your siblings if you have any, or maybe the people who live close to you, like your neighbors. And you know, this transit can really sort of up the tempo of your everyday life. You might be busy doing lots of little trips around your neighborhood, you know, getting through your to-do list during this time. Then Venus, the planet of art, beauty, relationship, she begins the month in your second house. This is the house of possessions. It's also the house of your income. So you might get a little bit of money luck during this cycle. Maybe somebody gives you a nice present, or maybe your boss gives you a little raise, or maybe you make some good sales at your job. And you also might feel a little bit more inclined to spend your money on really indulgent things, because Venus loves to indulge herself. So that could be maybe some art prints or some beauty items or something fashionable. Then on December 15th, she's going to jump into that third house that I just mentioned. Again, the house of neighbors, siblings. So when Venus comes into this house, it can really add a lot of harmony in your relationships with your brothers and sisters, also with your local, you know, the people who live close to you, like neighbors. And since the third house also represents communication, this is a wonderful time for being very diplomatic in how you speak to others. So if you've had arguments or communication issues with anybody recently, that'll be a great transit for kind of smoothing things out. Then Mars is still in Aries all month. Mars has been in Aries for a very long time, a few months now, because it did a whole retrograde cycle that just finished last month, but it's picking up speed now and finishing up the work that it needs to do. And this is all taking place in your seventh house of partnerships. So Mars can bring frustrations and flare-ups wherever he goes. So this may have been a bit of a rocky period in your relationship if you're in one. It may have been a little bit rocky if you've been trying to find a new relationship and, you know, maybe just the well kind of came up a little bit dry. The seventh house can also represent business partners too. So maybe you've been a little bit frustrated if you're in any type of partnership with anybody. But the good news about it is that as he's picking up speed and moving into a different house next year, it's going to be a fresh start for all of us.
It's going to be so nice. And man, I really feel for you, Libra, having Mars retrograde in your seventh house of partnership for several months is no picnic. But some other wonderful shifts are happening that are going to make next year feel very different too. And one of them is that Saturn and Jupiter are going to make the leap out of Capricorn, where they are right here, and over into Aquarius. And the first one to do that is Saturn, which does so on the 16th, quickly followed by Jupiter on the 19th. Aquarius, which is also your fifth house, is another air sign. It's very cerebral. It's very social. And the fifth house is a house of fun and entertainment. And play. And I think that it's hard to imagine anything more playful than for Libra than getting a group of people together to have interesting and fun exchange of ideas and banter. So this year, with Saturn being in your fifth house of social fun, you're going to find yourself having to take a lot of responsibility here and there for who you're friends with and how you handle those friendships. And who you consider your tribe to be. And also Jupiter is going to bring some wonderful expansion and growth in that area too. So this tonal shift is going to happen during December. And it'll be like a whole new world. Now, other things that happen here are a moon. Ah, yes, we have also, I want to mention that The sun moves into Capricorn, which is to say Capricorn season begins. And for you, the sun moves into the fourth house. And the sun tends to bring the spotlight of attention and energy and light and life force wherever it goes. And that's your fourth house of home and family. So this is a season for you to get cozy and snuggly at home and also possibly maybe more organized too. Capricorn certainly likes that. In that fourth house there. Now, there are a couple of moons to talk about. On December 14th, we have got a new moon and solar eclipse in Sagittarius, which we're calling worldview, beliefs, and resilience, because in typical Sagittarian fashion, it offers a choice between being opinionated and being tolerant. And that's a very Sagittarian dilemma. It falls in your third house of communication. So it's good to pay attention to the words that you use and to ask yourself, are you forcing your opinions on others, or are you benevolently listening to and integrating into your own philosophy their ideas too, so that you can expand? It's your choice. Now, the other moon comes at the very end of the month on December 29th. And that is a full moon in Cancer, which falls in your 10th house. And as is the case when Libra is rising, these are in the houses opposite to their own nature. So we have the Capricorn sun in the fourth house when Capricorn would rather be in the 10th, and the Cancer moon in the 10th house when Cancer would rather be in the fourth. And so this is always, you know, it adds its own layer of complexity. Full moons bring strong feelings. This one we've dubbed balancing, healing, and taking action because of its Chiron activity. Definitely you'll find yourself balancing home life with career and inner world with outer world and strength with softness. And then Chiron traveling along through your seventh house is engaged in a fairly long-term healing of your whole relationship arena, and that's a pretty important arena for you. And then this Chiron is going to have its impact during this moon too, and will help you to bring some assertion so that you can strike that proper balance. All right, well, that is the good stuff that we have for you. We hope you enjoyed it. We enjoyed making it for you. Thanks very much for watching all the way to the end. If you like this video, please do like, share, and subscribe. Let your friends know about us. And you can find more stuff like this on our website, pandoraastrology.com, where you can also find our services and our classes. And definitely check out our YouTube channel, Pandora Astrology. And we'll see you around the cosmos. Bye.
Bye-bye.